Hello trader, welcome back to Tipakis Forex. We'll be giving you our weekly Forex forecast. If you are new to this channel, don't forget to subscribe and turn on the notification button to get our weekly Forex updates. Just as we had stated this previous week on USDCAD that from here, we're expecting corrective structure here, all the way up to around this area or around this area. Then we said after this correction, we'll be expecting a drop. You can see that that's exactly what we got, and this drop is expected to break this previous low. Then from here, we can start either looking for an up move here like this, all the way up, breaking this previous high and breaking this previous high. That's what we are expecting. This up move also can only happen if this correction structure is complete. There's ways that you can check if this correction structure is not yet complete. If it's not yet complete, we might get an up move and another drop. Then this is when from here we can be getting this up move, breaking previous high all the way up to around this area. That's on USDCAD. This is NZDCHF. From NZDCHF, this is one of the pairs that we are currently trading. We focused this up move all the way up to around this area, and then we got this impulse move, and then from around this area we focused that we're expecting a corrective structure here, and then after this corrective structure is completed, we talked about continuation up. That's what we talked about this previous week. And if you're trading this NZDCHF, make sure that you are on the lookout for this up move all the way up to around this area. If you have not found any entry, be on the lookout for an impulse move this next week. Be on the lookout for an impulse move, because we might have an up move all the way up to around this area. Also from here, also this is NZDCHF. Now for NZDCHF, this previous weeks we focused on an up move from here. About 2 weeks ago we focused on an up move. We said that we're expecting an impulse move all the way up to around this area. This is what we stated in our previous videos, and then we say that this up move is expected to break this previous high and this previous high all the way up to around this area. So right now we managed to get an impulse move here, and this is currently a movement that we are trading the inner circle. And from here we focus on that we're expecting a corrective structure here, then that's when price can continue higher. Now one thing you need to keep in mind, this can just be a corrective structure, that's what we said, and then we also say that it can be a bigger corrective structure. Now this can give a movement similar to this, then drop, breaking previous low slightly, then from here price maybe it can go up, or because the market has not been that volatile enough, we can either get price moving like this, drop and then corrective structure, then drop to around this area. Then this is when we can either be getting a continuation up. This may be due to because the market has not been that volatile. Most pairs are not moving enough. They're not giving those big movements. Most pairs are just in those consolidation phases. Now you need to understand the market has different phases. That's what we teach in the inner circle. The market have different phases, and right now the market is not giving those big waves. Right now the market is just either moving sideways or just consolidating or giving corrections. You need to keep that in mind and be sure to know that you are patient enough, extra patient, if you need to be waiting for this big movements. Now that's on NZDCHF. We say that we're expecting an up move, and that is what we are expecting. If you look into this current pair here, we have Euro NZD. Now Euro NZD, we've been covering this down move. We say that we're expecting a drop here. This drop is expected to break previous low and break previous low here. That is what we talked about this previous weeks, and we are still expecting this drop here to take place to around this area here. That's on NZD. That's on Euro NZD. Alternatively, before we get this drop, it's also possible that we might get something like this. Then from here we might get this up move impulsively up to around this area. Then we can get this drop here, this drop that we're supposed to have here, we can have it here. That's the structure that we have on Euro NZD. This is AUDJPY. Now for AUDJPY, we're expecting our price to complete its corrective structure here, then we can get a drop here, and this drop is expected to break this previous low. Now also keep in mind, remember we say that most pairs are just in some corrective phases. You can see most pairs are not giving those huge movement as of now, so you need to be sure to remember that. On AUDJPY, just as we said, we're expecting this small corrective structure to complete, then we can get this drop movement. breaking previous low. That is what we are expecting on AUD JPY. Now this is NZD JPY. Remember, we focused at this drop here all the way down to this area. This is a focus that we made on NZD JPY, and then from here, this previous weeks, we got an impulse here like this, and then the past week we focus at a corrective structure here, and then we say the price would be continuing up after the correction. Now you can see that from here we got a down move, and then we got an up move here. So price might give a corrective structure here, then up like this. Then from here we might get a drop here, slightly breaking this previous low, and then we can get price moving up like this all the way up to around this area. Then after we get this up move, we can be assessing structure and giving you the next move. Now that is all that we have on NZD JPY. This is GBPUSD. Now for GBPUSD, this is what we are seeing. This is what we are foreseeing. We're foreseeing this up move here, and then it's expected to not break this previous high. We're expecting it only to end up to around this area, then we can get a drop here, and then this drop may break this previous low. That is the structure that we are seeing on GBPUSD. Now after we get this drop, we are expecting to get this up move here, breaking previous high and breaking previous high. Then from here we can be assessing what's next. Now another way to get up to around this area, is either from this level here to get a movement all the way up to this area like this, up to around this area. Then we can get the a down move here, then we can get a down move here. That is what we have on GBPUSD. It's either we get this up move and then down, then up after we get this down from here, this movement is very important. It's expected to break this previous high, and it's expected to break this previous high all the way up to around this area. Then from here we can either be getting a drop from here. We can be either be getting a drop from here like this. That is what we're expecting on GBPUSD. If we don't get this down move and then this up move from here, from after this up move, we can have price continuing up. Then this down move here, we can get this drop from here like this. It's a possible movement on GBPUSD, and that is what we are focusing. This is EURCAD. Now for EURCAD, remember from here we focused to get an up move like this. We focused at this up move, and the market has not been motivated enough to give such a movement. Your price has just been moving sideways. Until this structure that we had to give this up move has changed. So this is a setup that now we've been setting aside, because it has not been following our forecasted structure. It has just been moving sideways, and it hasn't been giving us an opportunity to be able to trade this up move. So if you'd have loved to trade this EURCAD, just set it aside and focus on pairs that are currently giving good movements. That's on EURCAD. We are currently setting it aside, and then let's go on to the next pair. This is NZDCHF, and this is NZDCAD, and on NZDCAD as well, there isn't much movement. The market is just moving up, down, up, down, up, down, just like that, up, down. So the market is just moving like this. There isn't much movement here, even though here we're expecting to get an impulse move like this, breaking previous high. This movement is not motivated enough. The market is not motivated enough to give this movement as of now, but we'll still be on the lookout. We'll still be watching out for such movements, because if they come, we'll be ready to take them. But as of now, the market isn't giving those much movements, just as we have said earlier, that usually around this time the market doesn't really move much. It's just giving consolidations, as most pairs are in the consolidation phases or in the corrective phases. So just be on the lookout for that the markets, they will be taking a longer time to make some movements, but more time than usual, based on the current phase which the market is on. The market is in a phase of consolidation. The market is not giving those huge movements as of now. So even on NZDCHF, we were expected to get an impulse move here like this. So the market now, it's giving up. Now it's giving a down move. What's next? The market can give something similar to this, then a drop, then give something like this, then corrective structure, then up like this. Instead of just the market moving from here impulsively like this, it can take a longer time. And usually when it takes a longer time like this, it might result in movements that are not reached. If the market was supposed to reach this level here by impulse, if it moves slowly like this, it can either move halfway, or it can either move just a little bit then get a drop. So that is what you need to keep in mind when you are looking forward for entries on such pairs. This is Euro AUD. Now, for Euro and AUD, we forecasted a drop here. We said that we're expecting a drop to break previous low and break previous low. That is what we forecasted, and we're still expecting this movement to continue. That's on Euro AUD. We're still expecting this drop to continue. This next week, there's a chance we might get a small correction and price can continue lower like this. That is what we are expecting on Euro AUD. We currently have USDJPY on this chart, and for USDJPY, this is what we focused on this previous week. We see that there's a possibility we might give a corrective structure, then we move 100 pips extra, 100 pips extra. Now, if you calculate this, if you calculate this moved pips, you'd realize that this is around 100 pips. Now, we say that we'll be getting 100 pips, then we can be getting a drop here like this, because this is a down move that we've been focusing, because looking at the overall structure here, structure is showing that we can expect this drop here. And then now, this is what we are expecting right now. This is what we're expecting right now from here. Just as we have stated this previous week, that there's a possibility to get one more extra up, then we can get a drop. Now, that is what we are still expecting on USDJPY. This is EURGBP. Now, for EURGBP, this previous week, we focused on an up move here like this. Now, this is a number that we've been focusing right around this area. We've been focusing this movement, but price has just been moving correctively, sideways, endlessly right now. Now, this is what we have mentioned earlier. Price is just moving sideways, sideways, like this, sideways, like this. So, this is not a tradable structure as of now. Until we get an entry here, this is when we can be looking for an entry to buy. Right now, we are just monitoring this. We have not found any entry as of now. Another pair which we've been expecting to get a drop by now from is GBPCHF. GBPCHF, we've been expecting this drop here like this, and price has just been moving sideways like this, endlessly. So that is what we are getting right now. So there's a possibility also that from here we can get just a small movement, and then still be looking forward for our drop here like this. That is what we're expecting based on structure. This is GBPNZD. Now, for GBPNZD, this previous week we got an impulse here, then we said we're expecting a drop, a corrective structure here, then we can be getting a drop. Now, as you see, we managed to get this up move, and now we get this drop. So next, there's a likely chance that we'll be moving up, slightly breaking previous high, then get a drop here like this. That is what we're expecting on GBPNZD. We're expecting a corrective structure, then we can get a drop. That is what we are forecasting as of now. This is USDCHF. Now, for USDCHF, we focus on this up move. We say that we're expecting an impulse move here, and then that is exactly what we got. Now, this week we extended this movement. We're expecting this movement to continue after we get our price moving like this, down, then up like this. This is what we're expecting on USDCHF. We're expecting a corrective structure here, then up move continues, breaking previous high. Now, if you need to understand how we focus some of these movements and how we count our waves, because sometimes you can hear statements such as we want to get a corrective structure here, then up. Sometimes you want to get a corrective structure, then up. So you don't know the wave counts, and this vary from time to time. Sometimes you can get a certain number of wave counts based on the certain scenario we have. So if you need to learn all that and understand how we get some of that, make sure to contact us to be part of our inner circle and understand how to read structure. On this pair, we have AUD NZD. AUD NZD, remember we said that we're expecting this corrective structure to complete, then price will be heading up. Price will be heading up. So be on the lookout for this up move. Be on the lookout. As soon as entry is ready, you can be looking for an entry to buy if you're not already trading the buy from the beginning here. So be on the lookout for this buy opportunity on AUD NZD. This is GBPJPY. Based on current structure, we're expecting corrective structure here, then drop, breaking previous low, and then we may get another up move. May get another up move here on GBPJPY. Now, remember, price has just been moving down, up, down, up, down, up. So this is what we are focusing on GBPJPY. We're expecting a corrective structure here, then a drop, then an up move here. That is what we are focusing. This is EURUSD. Now, for EURUSD, this is what we are focusing. We're focusing to get this up move, then down, breaking previous low, then we can get this up move here. Then from here, we can be getting a drop here like this, a drop. We'll be expecting a drop. That is what we are focusing. Up, down, up, down. Also keep in mind that before getting this drop here, based on how structure may behave, we can even get this up move all the way up to around this area and then get this drop. That is what we have for EURUSD. We can have up then drop, or we can have up down up then drop. This drop is very important, and this up move is very important, either from here or from here. Now that is what we have on EURUSD. This is gold. continue on the focus that we made this previous week on gold, we say that we're gonna expect a corrective structure here like this, and price might give an extra drop. Now this corrective structure, we got it here, and then we got a drop, and then we are getting an up move here like this. It's possible to get a corrective structure then up move like this, then this, all this can grow into a bigger corrective structure, then we can get a drop here. That is what we have on gold.